Welcome to this video on Continuing Professional Development, or CPD. We'll look at what can be included in CPD and some of the organisations and tools available to help you plan and carry it out. CPD is an important part of being a professional and is important for maintaining and improving your professional knowledge and skills. To start planning CPD, you need to think of the reasons for doing it. It could be something to maintain your competence or keep up to date. It could be something your employer wants you to do to meet organisational needs. Or it could be to develop you, either for a specific career or personal goal, or to enable you to upgrade to a higher level of professional registration. You then need to think which specific areas you want to develop. The UK CHIP self-assessment tool can provide a report of subjects to consider. And you may also identify them through your workplace development review, through the requirements of another professional body, if you're also a registered professional in another discipline, and also by thinking about your own career and personal plans. The Health Informatics Career Framework can provide guidance on potential career pathways and the qualifications or development needed for different job roles. In the current climate, many organisations are finding it more and more difficult to provide funding or time off for courses. Some other ways of doing CPD include reflection on practice. That's thinking about how you did something and how you might do it differently in the future. You might want to read journals and articles and produce reviews for your colleagues. You may be able to arrange work shadowing or a secondment. Being active in professional communities through online discussions and networking groups allows you to share knowledge and experience with other professionals. And this can be done through groups like the UK Faculty of Health Informatics, or BCS Assist. More groups are now hosting webinars and online meetings, so you don't need to travel or take so much time out. Finally, preparing training or explanatory material for others is a good way of consolidating your own knowledge. You can keep track of CPD activity using the UK CHIP online planning system and diary, or using a workplace system, or even devising your own. So, let's look at some CPD sources. The UK Faculty for Health Informatics and BCS Assist offer workshops, webinars, document updates and seminars. The Professionalising Health Informatics site, known as FHI, offers information about courses and qualifications. IRIM, the Institute of Health Records and Information Management, offers specialist qualifications for health records staff, and these often provide transferable contributions to academic courses. IFEMA, the International Federation of Health Information Management, offers downloadable education modules for health records practice. And finally, the UK CHIP Education Quality Assurance Scheme, or EQAS, accredits education and training which supports health informatics professionals. So look out for the logo on any courses you may be considering. All professionals need to carry out CPD to ensure they continue to develop their skills and keep up to date with new developments. We have looked at some of the ways you can do this and some of the many different organisations, resources and websites where you can find help. Why not have a look at some of the websites? And if you want more information, contact the organisations named.